Hello and welcome back to High Frequency Trading, a complete guide. If you have been following this series, you already know what HFT is and how it works. In this third episode, we are diving deeper into the core infrastructure, technology and systems that make high frequency trading possible. We will uncover what goes on behind the scene, from ultra low latency networks and co-located server to algorithmic engine and smart order routing. Whether you are a trader, quant or a technologist, understanding this backbone is crucial to building real-world HFT system. So buckle up, because today we move beyond concept into the real mechanic of high-speed trading. Let's get started. First is physical infrastructure. Under physical infrastructure, we are going to cover two things. One is co-location, one is custom cabling. So let's understand first what is co-location. So co-location is coming from the word co-locating. Right? So when the HFT firms co-locating their server from the place where they work to other places in the sense close to the exchange, or some of the HFT firms, they put their server inside the exchange building, that we call actually co-location, right? So co-location means the HFT firms, they rent space inside or next to the exchange data center. Now the rent is depend upon what is the rack size, how big is the rack size, how many rack you want to rent, and all these things. But this is really expensive. So now you understand the co-location concept. Why the HFT firms do that? Because to reduce the distance between the exchange and their server. To reduce the distance, they want to put their server inside the exchange building, so that the distance will be reduced. As a result, the latency will be very, very minimal. Okay, that is called co-location. Now coming to custom cabling. In custom cabling, so we'll talk about what are the cable that HFT firms use. So I'm going to talk about the most two important cable system they are used. One is your fiber optic cable. One is your hollow core fiber. So, and of course in microwave also I'm going to tell that, but the most important is basically your fiber optic cable and hollow core fiber. So what is fiber optic cable? Fiber optic cable is basically in the core. So the cable in the core, there is fiber or glass, because the data, or in fact the light, because that's a signal is converted into light, and that light is moved faster in a fiber or in a glass. That is called fiber optic cable. So inside the exchange building, if you are putting different servers, now to connect these servers, you can use that fiber optic cables. Now the latest invention is basically hollow core fiber. What is the hollow core fiber? That is because data travels faster in air than glass. So instead of using glass or fiber, there is a tiny air, hollow. Hollow means basically, I mean there is air inside that core. So the data will be moved very fast. Okay. So that is the difference between your fiber optics and hollow core fiber. I am not getting in the details of like how actually it is made of and all. For that, maybe I can make another video. But for now, you can just understand these things, that hollow core fiber is the latest invention where the data travels very faster, because there is air inside that core, and we know data travels faster in air than glass, right? So one more is basically microwave system, because microwave system is basically, you know, when if you want to communicate between two cities, right? You can send signal through air, right? That is your microwave system. So this is all about your physical infrastructure. Now let's talk about hardware stack. High frequency trading firms use custom servers like ultra lean Linux servers. They tune for real time performance, like reduced interrupts or CPU core pinning. And sometimes they disabling the power saving features as well. Now talk about FPGA or field programmable gate arrays. So you can say this is a kind of specialized hardware chip that execute certain trading logic directly on silicon, which is actually faster than software. So this is used for forging market data and trigger trades with minimal delay. In fact, some FPGAs can process data within 1 microsecond. Now talk about GPU. So high frequency trading firms use GPUs for signal processing, simulation, or any kind of machine learning models, which is basically pre-trade analysis. Before they execute the trades, if they want to do any kind of trade analysis by using the machine learning techniques or simulation, they can use the GPU. So now let's talk about software stack. In software stack, the first one is operating system. Mostly all HFT firms, they use Linux as their operating system, because as we know, Linux is very fast. And for kernel optimization, some process, you know, they do like isolating CPU cores or disabling background process, huge pages for memory or real-time scheduling. So all these things is actually optimize their kernel again. Now come to trading engine. So generally, trading engine handles market data, order book management, strategy logic, and order execution and risk check. So which programming language HFT use? They use low-level language like C++, Rust, or C. But mostly they use C++. Now coming to your order routing system. So mostly all the HFT firms, they use ultra-optimized fixed gateway for their order routing system. So there are two things here. One is they need order routing system for instantly send order to the exchange, and this must respond to market event in sub millisecond also, right? So for that, they use ultra-optimized fixed gateway, and some use proprietary protocols also. Now coming to network stack. In network stack, first one is low latency networking. So as I told you earlier, in low latency networking, kernel bypass or TCP stack offloading, they use. And for microwave or radio networks, like generally they use this between the exchange. So I think I cover everything, all the infrastructure and technology the HFT firms use to get a low latency, in fact, high speed executions. So that wraps off our deep dive into the powerful technology stack that fuels high frequency trading. These systems are engineered for speed, but technology is just one side of the equation, right? So in our next video, we'll shift gear and explore the core strategy behind HFT, how traders actually capitalize on speed to make profit in millisecond. So if you are curious about techniques like market making, statistical arbitrage, or latency arbitrage, make sure to subscribe and turn on notification. Until then, trade smart, stay curious, and I will see you in the next one. Thank you.